Hello everyone, my name is Daniela Pinilla. I'm a master's student working on the CUBO project. This week, instead of being in the CUBO site, we are here at the SNE Hall. This is the home of the Earth and Atmospheric Science Department at Cornell University. CUBO is currently going through the third section. We are going through 4,000 feet to 8,000 feet. This week, we are planning to drill, case, and cement that section before we arrive to the target section for CUBO. At this point, the principal source of information from CUBO are the cuttings. The cuttings are the truly hard rock and the truly real rock from the CUBO. So those cuttings are generated because the drilling bit is going through the rock, breaking that. And those small pieces of rock are coming from the underground to the surface. Then when they arrive to the surface, we wash them to remove that mud. Once the cuttings are like this, we can analyze them in the microscope, and that is vital for helping us to know in which geological formation are we in that exact moment. If we know the rock type in which we are right now, we can predict the rock that is coming in the next few hours, and that it's helpful for the drillers to take decisions about what are the drilling settings that they need to use and the mud properties. Some properties of the cuttings that we can analyze are the texture, the color, the mineral content, and the calcareous composition. Most of those properties are observed like in the microscope in a visual way, but some of them are performed with basic chemical tests. For instance, the shape of the cuttings give us information about what are the mechanical properties of the rocks, and that can help also the drillers to take decisions about the performance of the drilling. At the end of the drilling, we will have a complete inventory of rocks here at Cornell University from 0 to 10,000 feet. Together, the cuttings, the geophysical information, and the tests to be performed in the borehole are going to provide valuable information about the distribution of the geothermal reservoir here at CUBO. And it's valuable to understand the geothermal opportunity for the Earth source heat at Cornell. We will keep you updated about what is happening with CUBO now that we are getting closer to the target zone.